Hello guys, it's George here. Welcome back to my UI UX design challenge. I hope you are doing great. As you may know, yesterday I started designing a web app for a cryptocurrency exchange. So I think you are familiar with this stuff, but I already did some changes in here because I wanted to make sure that everything fits into those sections. And I did a few tweaks before I started recording. As you can see here, I added this section that lets you buy or sell a cryptocurrency. So exchange from Bitcoin to Electroneum. Because here it's the Bitcoin selected. And what I did was to add the dates in here. I added the price in Bitcoin in the right. I lowered the size of this font right here because it looks better, I think, and fits better with the 12 size. And I have to change it here. Also, and that's it. Also here I will do the opacity like that, 50% or maybe 70 or something like that. So I have to play here with the contrast. I have to do another chart right here. I want it to be gradient and I want to be different than this because this is just a quick one that I wanted to show. Those proportions are good here. The font sizes are good, at least in my opinion. So let me know guys, what do you think in the comments, and also on Dribbble, if you have a Dribbble account, you can follow me and comment on my shots right there. And yeah, basically this is self-explanatory. Here you choose the number of a certain cryptocurrency you want to buy or sell. In this case, Electroneum. Because Bitcoin is selected here, you want to change Bitcoins into Electroneum. So the price you want to pay in Bitcoin will appear here, so we have to do something like that because this is the last price. Here I want to do two buttons for plus and minus to easily add or lower the price or the amount. Here it will show the fee and the total price in Bitcoin that you have to pay to buy that amount of Electroneum. And it looks good. So let's get started, guys. I will start again tweaking those elements. And I think I will do here the section for sell orders, buy orders, and market history, as I have here on my sketch. Okay guys, so let's get started. Okay, guys, I think it's enough for this video because I don't want to take this too long. Basically, I did almost everything I have to complete here. The informations, the text. And tomorrow I will do that. And also I will finish all the design. I will add icons in here. I will create a logo. I will add an image here at the user. I will modify maybe those icons a little bit to have more contrast. I will add colors. I'm not sure about the main colors, like the background color and this one. I'm not sure about that. As it is now, I like it, but I will try different colors. I will try to work with colors to see how it looks. And also, I have to select a color for the call to action. That will be the same for this one. And also, I have to add a green and a red for high and low. So low will be red and high will be green. Also for the change, I will do, as it is now, it's with plus, I will do green. And when it's with minus, I will do red, of course. And yeah. As I'm speaking, I'm thinking what I should do, and yeah, I think it will be very good. Also, the chart color, it will be different. I want to be something similar to the call to action, but something that stands out a little bit, you know. So tomorrow I will take care of that and finish the design. So after that will be on Dribbble, and you will see the end result. Okay, guys, so have a great day, and thank you very much for watching.